Remember how I told you there might be a time where we don't get to stay together?
Well, I'm sad to say that day is today.
Why?
Because you have to leave, and I can't go with you. You have to go far away from here. Do you understand?
Is that Daddy?
Yes, that's Daddy. He's not your daddy anymore. He's sick. Listen, I'm gonna open that door and you're gonna run one way and I'm gonna run the opposite way.
Open the door, Mommy.
Emma, he's a creature now. He's gonna keep yelling. And more of them will come. And if more come, then die.
Stay with me.
You can do this. Break in any moment. You saw how Daddy bit me? I'm sick, Emma. I'm gonna be just like him. And when that happens, I will not be your... I will not be your mommy anymore.
No!
Yes, baby. I need you to be brave. Okay? I need you to run fast. Can you do that? Remember? Remember when Mommy used to take you to the park and you would run so fast? And Mommy would say, "Slow down, you're gonna fall." This time I need you to run. As fast as you can. Oh my God. Please survive.
Thank you. What's this wrong with mutants? Trying to get yourself killed? Come on, we need to get out of here. Come on! You can't just walk into a store like that. I mean, yeah, we all want to go in, but there's a right way of doing it. I mean, there's at least one mutant in there right now. By the sound of it, he's as hungry as we are. What?
I'm sorry, but there's a mutant in there, a zombie. But if you're hungry, you can come with me. Yeah, I have a wife and sister. They're cooking up a really big lunch. Yeah, I take care of them. I'm sure they wouldn't mind helping you out.
Everything's gonna be okay. We're almost there. Hope you like canned soup. Nobody makes it like my mom. Yeah, and, my mom, too.
Hey, Ma! I'm back!
She responded. Soup's on. Come on, let's go before it gets cold. What's wrong? Oh, that's right. I forgot. You can't hear. Look, why don't we both go in and then you can read her lips.
I said, come with me.
And then we'll both die. Is that what you want? You want to die?
Wait.
I need to hurt you. I need to hurt you. I just want a little loving. Who knows? You might even like it. Sorry, I didn't mean to hurt you. Yeah. Yeah. I understand. I just need some, you know? I mean, you look so, so good. Yeah, sure. Okay. Wow. I didn't know you were gonna be so cool about this. I'll be real gentle.
I'm not infected. I'm Lieutenant Colonel Sawyer, U.S. Army.
You one of those frontline troops?
I was.
Why the hell did you leave your post?
There is no post. There's no line. No military anymore, either. I just gotta get through here. Like I said, I'm not infected.
If I let you through here, you will be. This place is quarantined.
Be
will be infected, guaranteed.
But I need to get to the ocean.
The ocean. Are you out of your mind? Need to work on that tan? Those things are running crazy all through here.
I'll take the risk.
If I let you through there, you will be infected. And that's just one more of these things that I'll have to deal with.
Sheriff! We got another one!
Oh, yeah, settle down there, Gomer. All right, breathe. All right, take him out of his misery. Let's try it again, all right? A little lower, to the left. I'll be damned. You actually hit him? Go see if he has a watch on him.
Look, we're low on ammo. We got very little food left. And frankly, I'm all out of patience with you. So, I suggest you hit the road.
area is closed.
You don't have any ammo to spare. Getting through here no matter what.
Why the hell do you want to go in there?
I got my reasons. If you're not going to shoot me, I'll just be on my way.
I ran out of ammo 2 days ago. Ran out of food before that. I think everyone else is dead or infected.
Your sheriff is alive.
So are a few of the deputies.
I'm sure they haven't forgotten about you.
I used to live in there before the infection came. My mom never made it out. If you see her, please.
I can't make any promises.
If she's been infected, put her out of her misery. Do it quick. Don't make her suffer. I couldn't get her out in time. I failed her. Do you know what that's like?
All right. The coast is clear. You can come on down now. Hey, lady. You alive or what? Yeah, down here. Look at me. Let's go.
Help me.
Come on. What's the matter? What? What? Okay. Let's move out.
Don't shoot it! Or me. Don't shoot me either.
Put your hands on your head. How many others are here?
It's just me. Him.
Why are you keeping this thing alive?
I'm trying to learn about them.
You got any food or water?
I don't have food or water for anyone pointing a gun at me. But I do for friends. The zombie first fell in the hole, he was a lot faster and way more aggressive. You see, the fresher they are, the faster they are.
Can you read my lips, or am I speaking too fast?
You catching all this, Colonel? I figure as a military man, you'd be most interested to know how these things work so we can survive.
planning on surviving in the world with these things, sir.
Call me Wilson.
Yes, sir.
Well, the little lady here and I do plan on surviving this. As I was saying, you must stay away from the mutants who are newly infected. They still have the ability to run. Their bodies are okay for the most part, but their brains are gone and been replaced by a ravenous hunger. Now, if you come across one that's dying or starving, hell, anybody can outrun those, no problem. Oh, also, there's a dam not far from here. I'm certain it would be a perfect safe haven. It's virtually impenetrable. We can go there if you like. What do you think of that, Colonel? The dam would be the perfect place. We could survive with no worries of being attacked. I don't care how many mutants there are, they'll never get through those concrete block walls.
Sounds good. You two should go.
Us? What about you?
I gotta get to the ocean.
Well, fine. We have to take the coast road to get to the dam.
Good. I'll escort the two of you as far as the Pacific. You can go on from there.
Well, I'm not sure you understand. I've been planning this for months. You won't do better than the dam. It's a virtual fortress.
I dropped my sledgehammer a few blocks back and go look for it. Which way did we come in?
I'll show you.
No need to be shy here. Go ahead and top off your thermos if you like.
No, thanks.
I'm just trying to be friendly. What do you got in there, water? Well, I get it. None of my business. Forget I asked.
When the outbreak happened, my brigade was stationed outside Morocco to hold back the hordes. They gave us these top-of-the-line weapons, this new armor. But even that didn't help.
I saw that on the news before everything went dark. I heard the military was decimated.
There's only a handful of us that survived. It's hopeless. When I heard that the infection had spread to the U.S., I raced back.
Well, the airlines were already down by that time, right?
Yeah. I had to commandeer a boat just across the ocean. When I landed on the East Coast, took an abandoned car, but you know how hard it is to find gas these days.
Oh, yeah. Where were you driving to?
Wyoming.
It's a long trip.
Too long. By the time I made it home, by the time I made it to my wife and daughter, they are.
Sorry to hear that, Colonel.
The entire house was drenched in blood and bone. I've seen a lot of blood in my life, but never like that.
bodies were so mangled and chewed on. I couldn't tell them apart. The only thing I recognized was my wife's wedding ring.
I'm sure you know what you saw, but I'm wondering. All you found was her ring. Maybe they're still alive. They might have been forced to run off without it.
Still on a finger. Do you know they never got to see the ocean? They always wanted to, but seems like such a small thing now.
Try not to look back.
My wife, she lived in Wyoming her whole life. I kept promising I would take them to the ocean. I can never get around to it. I kept telling them maybe next year or for your birthday or anniversary. It doesn't matter now. My little girl, she would have loved it. Sometimes I imagine little face seeing it for the first time. Reacting to the vastness and the sound of it. I'll never know. So all I can do is give them a burial at sea. Spread their ashes.
If we're to survive this, we need to let go of all of our regrets. It's hard to keep the faith when things are this bad, but you must. Never give up hope.
I have nothing to hope for.
Do you think they'd have wanted you to give up? You've got the strength to go on, I can see that. All you need to do is walk in the light. The path of the righteous is like the light of dawn. You can reach that light if you keep your faith.
What are you, some kind of preacher or something? What did you do before the infection came?
I used to sell premium life insurance policies.
Salesman.
In a good one.
I'm sure you were. But please don't try to sell me on a future in this diseased wasteland. There's nothing left here but hunger and fear.
Don't give in to despair, my friend.
All I want is for this, all of this, to be over. I just want to get to the ocean. Sorry.
Better take a look at this.
Thank you both, but I am best on my own. I've had bad experiences with male survivors. Sorry.
She won't survive out there on her own.
Thank you.
And look what I found. It's full of gas, too.
Got a gun?
Yeah? Can you extra ammo for it? You got these?
Sorry about that. I have to make sure it works. Let's try to take that. Gotta get moving. If there's any mutants around, you can bet they heard that.
Don't do this, Colonel. She needs you. I know you want a way out. I know you think suicide is the answer to all your suffering. But the real answer is God. He won't abandon you. All you have to do is stay strong. He'll send you a sign if you look for it.
My wife and daughter are waiting for me. It's time I join them.
Thank you. There's no suffering. Just like home.
Like they could use some help. Glad to see you're still with us, Colonel.
I got that son you're telling me about. Stephanie, stay here. Let's go.
All right, folks, we gotta get a move on. The sound of the gunfire might have brought more. Come on. Now, don't touch the creatures. Be careful. Or the blood.
Please, don't hurt us.
We're only here to help.
We appreciate the help, really, but we've got nothing to give.
Don't worry. We don't want anything from you. Here. We're the good guys. All these kids yours?
No, they're orphans. We found most of them along the way.
Along the way?
We've traveled over 1,000 miles to get to a dam which is nearby. We've been living there for weeks.
Well, that was our idea, too.
It's swarming with zombies now. The entire place is infested. We have no idea how they got in.
The perimeter is secure. Maybe we should find them some shelter.
This is Colonel Sawyer. Maybe he can help. That is, unless he's leaving us.
I'm not going anywhere. Here to help. Here to stay.
Daddy?
Cosette?
Daddy! Daddy! Daddy? Mommy's dead.
I know.
we're gonna be okay.
I did find some people food, but I gave that to the kids.
It's okay. I've eaten worse. You know, I was really looking forward to eating fresh vegetables.
How's that?
There's a lawn at the dam with good soil for planting. And since there's water and electricity there, I was mowing the lawn and planting seeds. It's going to be perfect.
The only place with water and electricity and cement walls to keep us safe.
Well, it's not so safe now.
Well, we're safe enough here. I'm sure the Colonel and I can come up with a plan to retake the dam.
Look, I'm glad that Cosette found her father. I mean, really.
But
the rest of us don't want anything to do with that man.
I don't understand.
Her father, the soldier, we don't want anything to do with him.
Why?
You know why. You know what the military did.
I'm afraid I don't.
Weren't you watching the news before it stopped?
Of course.
When did your grid go dark?
A long time, almost a year ago.
Oh, okay. Well, my area went dark only about 4 months ago. Before that, we were focused on the news day and night. Hold on. I have a solar charger for my player. See if it has enough power. Here we go. This is the last broadcast the government put out.
The president and vice president are dead. I was the Speaker of the House, and I'm now your acting President Gates. I'm here to address the infection which is plaguing the entire planet.
Citizens of the United States, your leaders, along with other leaders, have made a tragic miscalculation. Our efforts seemed justified because we were desperate. There were no other options. The world was massively overpopulated. The pollution problem was insurmountable. Food and oil shortages were looming. What we did was an effort to save the civilized world. According to our calculations, the only way to save the world was to eliminate entire populations. Our efforts to control lesser populations through sexually transmitted diseases and regional wars proved to be too slow. Yes. Yes, I admit this. Now that it's the end of us, I have no fears. My wife and children are dead. My grandchildren became infected. Had to put them down. The point is that no one can kill my family now if I speak the truth. The wealthy have always been in power, not your elected officials. And they decided that since Africa produces nothing but poverty and disease, they were the obvious ones to be eliminated. Again, please believe me, we did this so that the more evolved races could continue to thrive. We didn't do this to be villains. We did this to be saviors. By creating a continent of bloodthirsty mutants, we could look like heroes to the bleeding hearts when we shot them down. Not people, infected mutants. How did we infect them, you ask? Decades ago, our scientists discovered the remains of gold miners who died from a mysterious plague in the 1860s in a California ghost town. They also found the cause, a meteorite that they had cracked open, hoping to find riches, but instead they found the most virulent airborne pathogen this world has ever known. Five decades, but we found a way to weaponize it. And then after years of deliberations, secret deliberations, the world powers decided it was time to use it. But once we did, we lost control of it. Please believe me, we did this to save the civilized world. I know that brings little comfort now. I'm revealing this information for one reason. If anyone survives this, please learn from our mistakes. Be good to each other.
How can we stay with a soldier? He worked for the ones who were to blame for this. He's part of them.
I think you missed the point of the whole message. Besides, he's not responsible. You think they told the colonels about their plans? This poor guy lost his wife to the infection. And until today, he thought he lost his daughter, too.
He might have known. That's enough for
him. Come on.
How can we trust him?
I'll secure the dam for us. That's how.
About that, Colonel. The lady says the place is swarming with zombies.
I want a safe place for my daughter. I know you do, too. You said it yourself, Wilson. It's our best bet.
I thought you said you were low on ammo.
I got 4 clips left. That I have to do.
Don't do us any more favors.
I didn't have anything to do with that video you're talking about, ma'am. But I am a soldier in the U.S. Army.
Is that supposed to mean something?
It means I kill them all. Or I'm gonna die trying.
There's a hidden entrance. That's how he escaped. I can tell you where it is.
kill them all. I'm gonna do one more final sweep, but looks like we got ourselves a new home.